Hello, Bulldogs. Welcome to this week's news show. I'm Owen Cesario.
And I'm Carson Kleinalter. This week, we'll be covering how sports have changed due to the pandemic.
We'll take a closer look at C4 classes this year.
Holiday cards for United Way.
And a day in the life of a student during e-learning.
Columbus North girls basketball team won against Southport with a score of 71-22 Tuesday night. BNN reporter Darren Riley sat down with assistant coach White to talk about how the pandemic has affected the way they prepare for games and how events are meant to take place.
BNN sat down with coach White to discuss how the pandemic has changed the way the basketball team prepared for their season.
The way we tried to stabilize our mental focus is just to approach it as, you know, every day we have together is a day that we have to cherish. It's a blessing each day that we get to be together and get to participate in basketball. So we just kind of approach it as we've got today, so let's make the best of it. It hasn't changed a whole lot other than as coaches a lot of times we'll go and scout teams live, but with the restrictions in attendance we're not able to do that. So we had to rely pretty much on film as far as preparation of other teams, but as far as the way we approach it with our team, things haven't changed a whole lot with that. It does a little bit, you know, obviously with a smaller number of people there, it's not quite as loud, as maybe not as energetic, but really once the game starts, we're kind of focused on what we need to do, and we kind of have to bring our own energy, and that's where you rely on your teammates to have that enthusiasm and kind of pick each other up. Practices aren't too much different for the players themselves. We try to keep everybody spaced when we're talking and things of that sort, but as far as the actual activity, things aren't too much different. As coaches, it's a lot different since we have to wear masks all the time. So that's a little bit of a change for us, but again, we just try to focus on staying distanced as much as we can throughout practice.
This is Darren Riley reporting for BNN.
With students going into virtual learning, reporter Luke Rutherford shows us what a day of e-learning looks like to most students.
Hi. Today I'm making a video of basically what it feels like to be a student in today's e-learning environment and the way that, you know, a lot of us feel working in a place that can be so lonely at times. It can be hard to express yourself and your work and the things that you say and the things that you do. Really hard to manage that versus actually being in school. And so this is a day in my life, in a high school student's life, during this pandemic. So I've just finished up my health work for the day. Luckily, it didn't take me way too long. You know, health is usually pretty easy. And, you know, as you can see, it's learning in the background, open right here. And technically, since it's an A day, I have my lunch right now. It is 11:41, and I have lunch until 12:13, technically. So I'm gonna go make some food, I'm gonna eat some lunch, and we're gonna get on with my Spanish work, and then I'm done for the day. I have a super short A day because I have resource fourth period, and there isn't much you do for resource virtually, and so, yeah. So basically, I'm about to eat lunch. It's my lunch time. It's 11:50 now, and I'm ready to eat, so I'm gonna make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich or ramen or something. I'm gonna film it all. This is like my own little cooking show in my humble abode, and so yeah, I'm super hungry and I'm super ready to eat, so. Thank you. you guys can see, right now I am doing doing some Spanish homework, Spanish work, whatever you wanna call it. And I'm sitting here doing my Spanish work, and this is my last class of the day. I'm about to wrap it up. I took a little bit of a break, ate my food, I listened to music for a minute, and I'm about to wrap up my school day for the day. And yeah, so I'll check back in with you guys when I am finished. Boom. I'm sitting on my bed right now. I'm done with all of my schoolwork for the day. It's been really chill. I got my room back here, big old tripod right there, my desk, everything, my setup, and yeah, so I've finished everything for the day finally, and now I can just chill for the rest of the day, do what I'd like to do for the rest of the day, just like it was a regular day. You know, once I'm done with school, obviously, I can go about my day, do whatever, but we've wrapped this up. As you can tell from all the recaps I've given you, it's been relatively relaxed. It's very relaxed, it is, but it's also very lonely. And you know, living my normal life at home, chilling, making food, doing work, eating more food, doing more work. And now we're here at the end of the day. And yeah, thank you guys for watching. And I will see y'all next time. Thanks for watching, by the way. I forgot to tell you that.
BNN reporter Molly Hotek sat with Curtis Abendroth and Luke Akalaya to give us an insight on C4 classes, culinary arts, and biomedical innovations.
BNN sat down with Curtis Abendroth and Luke Akalaya to discuss the C4 classes meeting in person during e-learning.
My name is Luke Akalaya. I'm a senior at Columbus North High School, and I am taking biomedical innovations first period on 8-8.
All right, so I'm Curtis Abendroth, and I'm in a culinary arts one. So that's what I've been doing since the beginning of the year.
So it's a really project heavy class focused on making biomedical innovations, basically studying things in the biomedical field and making new innovations and working on understanding the scientific process, making your own experiments, designing your own experiments, and carrying out your own experiments.
On a typical day-to-day basis, Chef will usually just bring us all into the kitchen and she'll either demo something or she'll run through a recipe really quick with us, then hand us the recipe. Then she'll just supervise us while we like go through the recipe, and then she'll answer any questions we have. On days we aren't in the kitchen, we will be just in the classroom doing normal book work. Ever since we've gone to e-learning, we've been in the kitchen every day cooking, so that's been pretty nice, actually.
Showing up only for C4 classes has affected my transportation options, because even though I can drive myself, I don't have my own car. So back when I had to go for the entire school day, it was a lot harder to take my car to school because my parents wouldn't be able to use it all day. But now that I only have to take it for one period, it's a lot easier to leave at home.
Not me. I drove to school every day, but it's definitely affected my fellow classmates, because like almost like a third of all the people that did show up are showing up now. Not me though. I've always driven, so it hasn't really been an issue for me.
Curtis and Luke talk about how e-learning has affected them.
I think getting an in-person education for certain C4 classes is still an unnecessary risk that we're taking, especially in a class like biomedical innovations. I'm certain that we can put it completely virtually if we really so wanted to in HBS and MI, human body systems, medical interventions. You sometimes dissect things, so I understand coming in for that, but for a class that's typically reliant on group projects that are mostly online anyways, I think bringing us in person and sitting us in rooms together is an unnecessary risk that we shouldn't be taking.
I definitely think it's important, because a lot of this stuff, it's just not the same class if you're doing like, if you're not doing any hands-on work. It's definitely important to actually get that hands-on experience. That's like the big reason people take their C4 class, is just because it just opens up that opportunity to actually work with some equipment.
I don't think coming in really has benefited me in terms of learning things. I think that if we were to take biomedical innovations completely online, I would still get the same level of work done, especially in the last couple weeks. I really don't think that being in person has made it easier for me to learn, or I guess I should phrase it, I don't think that not being in person would make it more difficult.
Yeah, I definitely do, just because I personally hate doing it online. So it's nice to actually come in and still have like a normal class every day. I definitely enjoy that.
Well, I can understand like show choirs and bands needing to stay and come in person, because from personal experience, it's very difficult to have those kinds of extracurriculars completely virtually. Last year, our orchestra and bands were very difficult to participate in virtually, so having the ability to come in to participate in that is very nice. And that same logic does extend to the C4 classes, such as like BI and HBS and MI. It is in the school's mind, better to have someone teach you in person. And since HBS and MI are very lab reliant, it makes sense to put those in person. So I understand why the school would want to keep C4 classes in person.
Whenever I remember Chef told us, well, Chef is basically our teacher. She told us at the beginning of the year that like C4 classes and like normal classes are kind of separate in a way, to where the people who like control C4, I guess, said they aren't gonna like shut down any of their C4 classes until the Board of Health or whatever specifically tells them to. So I think it's actually like a separate thing than like all the normal classes. I don't know too much about it, but that's basically what Chef told us.
This is Molly Hotek reporting for BNN.
The graphic design and layout class is working on donating over 500 holiday cards to the United Way. Reporter Josh Owens and Carson Kleinhalter sat with a couple of students to tell us more.
BNN sat down with a couple of students in the graphic design and layout class to get more information on the cards they are making for United Way.
Okay, what interests me most about this project is that we are getting to work with the community and getting to work on a new project that we had never done before.
This project interests me the most because like you can get your designs out there, and it's a great thing for the community as a whole.
We're making about 11,000 cards for each donor, and we're working on just getting the artist's name out into the community.
We're making about 11,000 cards, and it's basically to get the students, the designers out there, and it's to it's kind of like a gift to the high donors of United Way.
These cards are important to people because they're making them feel loved and a part of something, and that's our main focus.
These cards are important for people because it shows like the joy in the holidays and coming together and just having fun.
I think these cards are going to make people feel loved and bring happiness into their holidays. It's just something to look at and smile about.
I think they'll make it kind of shows like community and coming together.
This is Carson Kleinhalter reporting for BNN.
That's it for today, Bulldogs. I'm Elvin Cesario.
And I'm Carson Kleinhalter. Have a great weekend.